Some 400 kilometers from Japanese shore on Tinian Island, the Boeing B-29 Superfortress nicknamed Enola Gay is ready for takeoff. In its bomb bay is the world's first ever atomic bomb. Two other planes are also prepared to accompany the bomber, the great artiste carrying instruments to measure the blast and necessary evil to take photographs. Piloted by Colonel Paul Tibbets, the Enola Gay took off at around 2 a.m. on the 5th of August 1945 on its mission to Hiroshima. Earlier on the ground, Parsons the weaponeer unloaded the cordite explosive charges from the bomb in a fear of a crash at takeoff, and at around 6 a.m. the charge was placed back in with the help of Lieutenant Morris Jepson and was now fully armed. The bomber is detected by Japanese radar at 7 a.m. No visual confirmation of the bomber was made on the ground, and life continued in Hiroshima as usual. The bomber is picked up by radar again at 8, and warnings are broadcast to take shelter, but many ignores. A few minutes later, the crew of Enola Gay make visual contact with Hiroshima. They receive a message that indicates good weather over the city, so the mission proceeds as planned. The exact target is a T-shaped bridge at the center of the city. The bomb is dropped at approximately 8:15, and after falling for 44 seconds, a multitude of safety triggers fire to detonate the little boy at around 600 meters above ground. It is detonated in the air as to spread the blast pressure over a larger area and expose more people to thermal radiation. The detonation begins with the explosion of the cordite bags, which launch a hollow tube of enriched uranium towards a target rod of the same substance. On their own, the uranium masses are subcritical, but once merged, they reach critical mass turning supercritical. A nuclear chain reaction begins where uranium molecules are hit by neutrons creating fission products, which create more neutrons that then collide with more uranium. The number of collisions rise exponentially to create an explosion. The fireball spread to 370 meters in diameter at its widest and reached the temperature of the surface of the sun. Almost everything was destroyed within a 1.6 km wide area, and nearly everyone was killed by overpressure within a 3.5 km wide area. After the release of the bomb, the B-29 turned around in a so-called survival maneuver. Just 55 seconds after the drop, the bomber felt the first shockwave, and another 8 seconds later, another shockwave could be felt by the crew. This was due to the altitude at which the bomb was detonated. The bomber returned to Tinian at 2:58 p.m. alongside the two instrument planes. A few days later, the Enola Gay would take off on another mission to Japan, but with an improved nuclear bomb called the Fatman. As a result of the operation, around 66,000 people lost their lives and a further 69,000 were injured.